my name is Zoe Kiefer, and I'm a research associate in Dr. Jason Ross's group within the Animal Science Department at Iowa State University. Today we're going to discuss pelvic organ prolapses and identifying some biological factors associated with them. This project is part of a larger project doing research on improving pig survivability. Our team focuses on research and extension and includes experts across a variety of fields from Iowa State University, Kansas State, and Purdue University. This project is funded by the National Pork Board and the Foundation for Food and Agricultural Research. The goal of this project is to reduce the overall mortality within the U.S. commercial swine industry. For more information about our work, please visit our website, www.piglivability.org. Pelvic organ prolapse, which from here on out I will refer to as POP, incidence has been increasing throughout the U.S. swine industry within the past 10 years. POP is an anatomical disorder defined by one or more of the pelvic organs, which can include the uterus, rectum, and/or vagina, pressing against or out of the vagina. In previous studies, we have shown that POP makes up about 21% of all sow mortality. There is no good understanding of the root causes or the biological factors associated with POP. In addition to POP being a concern for mortality, it is also a welfare and economic problem. To evaluate risk for POP, we developed a perineal scoring system to evaluate individual sows during late gestation. Each sow is only scored while laying down, and visual markers such as vulva and perineal region swelling, as well as protrusion, are evaluated. A perineal score 1 is considered little to no risk and displays none of the visual signs. A perineal score 2 is considered moderate risk and may display some swelling or protrusion. Perineal score 3 sows are at high risk for prolapse and display severe swelling and protrusion of the perineal region, and in some cases may even have the beginnings of a prolapse. To learn more about our scoring system, please see our video, Perineal Score and Pelvic Organ Prolapse, on our website. Out of the 213 animals scored in this study, 1.5% of perineal score 1, 0.8% of perineal score 2, and 23.1% of perineal score 3 sows subsequently prolapsed. So we can assume our system is a good predictor of prolapse. We observed sows differing in perineal scores had different risk of POP, so we hypothesized that sows differing in perineal score would have differences in their vaginal microbiome. In an initial study, we went on to two commercial sow farms and scored animals during gestation week 15. Samples were then collected from perineal score 1 animals parity matched to perineal score 3. We collected vaginal swabs to evaluate the microbiome as well as some blood samples. We then extracted the DNA from the vaginal swabs and performed 16S-R RNA sequencing to evaluate the vaginal microbiome. In the graph here, the yellow represents perineal score 1 sows and the red perineal score 3. Each point on this graph is an individual sow. When analyzing differences between perineal score 1 and perineal score 3 animals, we found significant differences on a whole community level. The statistical difference in overall microbial communities were found using a NOSIM and having a p-value of 0.008. Individual microbes were then sorted into operational taxonomic units, and or OTUs, in order of abundance within our samples. OTUs can be identified down to a genus or species level. We wanted to look into individual microbes in hopes of finding any similarities to those of other known diseases or ones that could be key indicators of POP. Unfortunately, not much is known about sow vaginal microbiome. However, human vaginal microbiome research has shown shifts in the microbiome to be associated with disease such as pelvic inflammatory disease and bacterial vaginosis. There have also been individual microbes to be associated with those diseases. We can also compare microbes in swine intestinal tract that are known to cause inflammation as well. We observed 89 OTUs that were significantly different between perineal scores. When evaluating the 100 most abundant OTUs, 24 were significantly different amongst perineal scores. In this graph, yellow indicate perineal score 1 and red perineal score 3 sows. 12 OTUs were more abundant in perineal score 3 sows, while 12 OTUs were more abundant in perineal score 1 sows. So, in conclusion, we have shown that perineal score 3 sows are more likely to experience POP than perineal score 1 sows. We have also observed distinct differences between the vaginal microbiome between perineal score groups. Because of this, we can focus research on individual OTUs and potentially associate them with POP. Be on the lookout for more videos of our findings linking biological factors to POP. Thanks for listening!